And now I am pleased to present a recent alumnus of Suffolk to also bring greetings today. Joseph Serra graduated in 2010 with a BA in Communications and Journalism with a concentration in Media Studies. During his undergraduate years, he interned at Wynn Interactive, a litigation and multimedia consulting firm, where he was a video and multimedia producer. He earned a full-time job following graduation. 9 months ago, he became senior video producer for D50 Media, a full-service marketing agency. He manages projects from idea to production and delivery, including work with creative teams to develop effective uses of TV, radio, web, social media, email, and events. All the while, Joe has stayed in contact with Suffolk and his faculty mentors. He works with other Suffolk alums on a regular basis. Most importantly, he has been able to be a mentor himself to current Suffolk students and has been a guest speaker at a number of media classes. And on move-in day, just this past Sunday, Joe could be seen serving as a volunteer member of our move crew, schlepping student belongings into 150 Tremont and greeting parents and new students as they arrived. Recently, he was elected to the College of Arts and Sciences Alumni Board of Directors. This role will allow him to continue his contributions to the university and assist in engaging other younger alumni in contributing as well. I am proud to welcome back Joseph Serra.
Thank you, Dean Stoll, and thank you to Suffolk University for asking me to be here today. I am honored and privileged to speak to you, the class of 2018. Congratulations on beginning this next chapter of your life. I had an opportunity, as Dean Stoll mentioned, to meet a number of you this past Sunday, where I was lugging your suitcases, refrigerators, stuffed animals, and flat-screen TVs out of your parents' cars and into your new homes for the next 8 months. I see some of you here, trust me. It was a pleasure to get to know you in the brief amount of time we had together, and I know our paths will cross again soon. I want you to take a minute to look around. Look at the person sitting next to you, look at the people on the stage and to the left and right of you. These are the people that are going to become your classmates, your teammates, your professors, and your closest friends. But most importantly, these are the people that are going to become your colleagues. You may not realize it now, but once you graduate, get a job, and start paving the path to your career, the people in this room are going to be the people by your side. You're going to call upon them for a favor, for advice, and maybe one day collaborate and start a company together. These are your colleagues, and this is your network. When I was a sophomore at Suffolk, I took a documentary filmmaking class. One of the projects was to shoot a documentary for a nonprofit organization. Everyone in the class was assigned different roles. Some were script writers, some were camera operators, and myself and another classmate, Matt, we were assigned to be the directors. I obviously considered myself to be Steven Spielberg, where Matt considered, I considered him to be more of a Steven Soderbergh. If you don't know who Steven Soderbergh is, well, that's exactly my point. The project went off without a hitch, the client was happy, and Matt and I became close friends and continued to work together throughout our time at Suffolk. As much as I enjoyed directing, it wasn't until that project that I realized I wanted to become a producer. There was something about managing and overseeing every detail of a production that I was drawn to and that I loved. Also, if a film wins an Oscar for Best Picture, it's the producer who accepts the award. In 2010, during our senior year, Matt started to write a screenplay that he was calling Uneven Strings. It was a short film. He asked me if I'd produce it, and I gladly said that I would. A project that Matt thought would only take a few months to complete ended up taking 3 years once I got involved. We auditioned 80-plus actors, we scouted locations all over Boston, and we rewrote the script over and over again. It wasn't until the spring of 2011 that we actually rolled cameras and started to film Uneven Strings. After 3 months of filming, we wrapped production and went on to successfully raise $10,000 through Kickstarter campaign so we could hire editors, sound designers, and musicians to bring the film to life. In the fall of 2013, almost a year ago, I stood on stage at Suffolk University's Modern Theater and introduced the film and premiered it for the first time in front of a packed house. As I looked out into the audience that night, I couldn't help but notice all the people that were such a big influence in getting me where I am today. And all of those people had one thing in common, Suffolk University. I wouldn't be standing here in front of you today if it wasn't for the experiences and the opportunities I had while attending Suffolk. Suffolk is a school that you're able to get involved in beyond your everyday classes. I remember when I was just starting at Suffolk, one of the first people I met was my orientation leader, Amy. Amy was a member of the Performing Arts Office, and she told me that they were looking for students to join. I was involved in theater during high school, and I immediately knew that this would be a great opportunity. So I signed up. I was a sound designer for the annual Fall Fest performance, which is just right around the corner. And I met some great people. I made new friends, and I felt like I'd been there for years. It was a perfect way to begin my freshman year, and it was a perfect way to get involved. No matter what you're interested in, whether it's politics, volunteering, finance, music, science, skiing or snowboarding, dance, improv, or even paintballing, there is a club you can join at Suffolk. And if one of those clubs doesn't appeal to you, you can even start your own. I encourage everyone here to join a club this fall. I'm confident that once you do, you will be involved for the next 4 years. Beyond Suffolk's four walls, there are even greater opportunities for you to grow as a student, as a young professional, and as a voice for Suffolk University. Suffolk is located in the heartbeat of Boston and has affiliations with sports teams, news outlets, nonprofit organizations, and companies not only through this city, but across the country. In a couple years from now, when you're looking for an internship, or after you graduate and you're looking for a job, you're in the best location and you are connected to an invaluable network. I challenge you to get involved at Suffolk, create bonds with your classmates, and establish relationships with your professors. Those are the relationships that you're going to look to after you graduate. Those are the relationships that allowed me to grow as a student and continue to grow as a professional today. So get involved, meet people, work hard, and make it count over the next 4 years. Suffolk is more than just a place for you to create a living. Suffolk is a place for you to create a life. Thank you.